In the previous lecture, we learned how to display a single model on a view. In this lecture, we shall be learning how to display a collection of objects on a view. Collection could be coming from a database table. It could have been created by adding records manually. Whichever way we create it, our objective is to display an entire collection of objects on a view. For this, we have already created a table TBL Airlines, IDs auto numbered, flight name, takeoff and landing. We have created 3 or 4 columns. You can create any database. We used SQL Server Compact, varchar50, varchar50, varchar50. This is primary key identity. First of all, let us get the collection. For this, we shall add the entities for this, add folder, add new item, data, ADO.NET entity model, DB, airlines, sorry, we'll call it mod airlines, click add. As usual, click next, click next. Finish. This is what is generated for us. Now we shall begin to prepare for displaying this. For this, right click on the controllers, add controller, home controller. Index action is already created for us. Let us add the view for this. Right click, add view, picking index, view engine is Razor. Generally, I recommend when you want to display collection, don't choose this option, create a strongly typed view. Designer always creates a wrong thing for you. And if possible, never use this option, add that line, add that model yourself. We leave this empty because we are going to use the view start file. And this is a normal view, so nothing to be tick marked here. Click add. This is the view that is added for you. From safety point of view, run it, see whether at least this one is working or not. So we are getting the output. It means so far it is working. And now let us come to our home controller. This is the point where we shall query the database and return the data to the view using DB. Since the namespace has to be added, the best thing is to write it here using dot entity models. It's always better to add your entity models namespace at the top so that you can very easily catch hold of your classes. The context is always generated based on the name of the database that you provide. It was DB Airlines. So simple.